everything. All right. There we are. We can start this little timer over here real fast, so I don't play this forever as I could. There we are. Set that. No. It's not the right time. No. No. Stop it. There. Okay. So yeah, I'm just gonna go back and play some more Hyrule Warriors. I've been playing this a ton since Saturday. Oh, right. As it turned out, I did have all the other DLC. It just, you know, didn't register. I guess because... I don't know. Nonsense. I'm just trying to figure out what I want to do. Right now, I think I'll just play through some more of the actual main adventure mode. Yeah. I've been playing a bit more of these maps and everything. Might do one of the ones that I failed to get everything on last time, but... Yeah, you know, let's start with that. But which one? This one is the... That's the kill a bunch of enemies. That's a pain in the ass. Yeah, let's just do this. This should be easy. It's just I got hit too much. Oh, also, video quality should be better than it was on Saturday. I figured out something that I was doing wrong with console streaming, and I fixed that. So that should be good now, though, unless the setting... Let me just double check a thing real fast. I just want to make sure that setting doesn't reset. No, okay, we're still good. This might go out for a second. Yeah, alright. Don't worry, this is all as it should happen. Say the one moment, please. Oh, good, yes. Yeah, let's get this on video. Nope, that's not right either. Whoops! There we go. Fixed. Alright. Let me just take a quick look at this map real fast. I need to get that fairy on the bottom, take that middle map that probably has the key, and then I just need to gain enough kills. Alright. Lower the volume on this just a tad. Don't want that being picked up. Gotta be careful. I've already lost 3 hearts, which is not good. When you're going for rank. Good shit. Just fucking up. No. No, this isn't a Zelda MOBA. It's a Zelda Dynasty Warriors. Two very different things. No, I guess you could say it's kind of like a MOBA. But no, not at all. Now I'm just having thoughts about a Nintendo MOBA. Nintendo, I have plans to reach all the hip young kids. Alright, so I'm going to try not to pick up hearts at all, because if I get below, how many hearts are we talking here? If we get below 10, I have fucked up royally. As I continue to get hit, so we're almost at 6. We have almost hit the danger zone. Hey. Metroid deserves better than a MOBA. Metroid is a good ass. I should stream a Metroid. That's what I should do sometime. I should just, in a single session, beat Super Metroid. I could do that. I could do that easy. Oh no, there's space in trouble. What have I been doing? Oh, this man. And you're safe. Ah, I see. Hello. Yeah, let's hope to Christ if they ever make another Metroid game, Team Ninja is involved. Well, no. It was... what's his face, the director that made most of the problems with Other M. It wasn't Team Ninja. Team Ninja did the combat, which actually in their defense wasn't in against them, not in their defense. What are you doing? Alright, it looked like that's just her standing pose. It looked like Rudo was charging something up. The combat. Or the gameplay? What do you call it in a Metro game? It's not really combat. But whatever. The whatever in Other M. No, I leveled up. Well, that fucks with my whole keeping track of health thing. That wasn't spectacular either. It was mainly spam the dodge button and win. One more general unit over here. Other M's gameplay was okay. It was just very easy, I guess is my complaint. Sakamoto, thank you. That's the guy who was real weird about Samus. That guy. I need to get these fuckers out of this doorway. Duh. All right, let's not do the animation lock stuff that is getting me owned. Yeah, I think the real issue of this map that is just getting me completely wrecked is the, these Poe enemies can really mess you up if you give them a chance. Sneak in right there. Oh, you never played a Metroid or a Vania? You should try them out. Both are pretty good. Anything that is 2D in a Vania or solid, anything that isn't other M in a Metroid is at worst okay. What's it called? Hunters had problems, but even that was comparable. Like, the worst thing that had was, why am I fighting the same boss again? And Jesus Christ, this is just why. Alright, so I do need the key, which I need the fairy down here for. Yeah, Harmony of Dissonance. Pretty okay. Though, a little MMO-y. A little grindy. A little bit of a grind, that game. I should stream that game. There's a lot of games I should stream. I'm good on kills. The problem is this is a key level, so I need to kill this to get the fairy, to break the seal, to get the key, to open up the final. Yeah, we are getting actual Zelda E right here. What the fuck hit me? Also, I just don't like this guy. I'm worried about getting animation locked and just getting destroyed by one of the projectiles. I don't care about that place. Harmony of Dissonance was the... Oh no, Harmony of Despair was the console one that was a little grindy. Okay. Dissonance is pretty alright. Dissonance... Wait, no, fuck. I don't even know anymore. God, Castlevania and your stupid-ass naming schemes. Was Dissonance the PS2 one? I think Dissonance was the PS2 one. If you're talking about the GBA one with Juiced, that one's actually alright. Oh, are you talking about... God, what's it? It's one of the Lords of Shadows, I think Mirror of Fate. That's the 3DS one. I haven't heard good things. I haven't played that one, mainly just because everybody was like, nah, this isn't too great of a game. kind of want to do my 3 charge because that does damage, but I know I don't want to be animation locked. I think the only passable Lord of Shadows game was the first one. My understanding is the 3DS one is not great, and the second console one is bad. I somehow took no damage. Oh, wait. A trick. Nice. There we go, that's a win. Lords of Shadow had potential. Also, yes, I'm fighting Zelda because this is just adventure mode, so they're set maps. Oh, right, forgot, there's a boss. Whoops. Oh, okay, wait, hold up. That guy needs to die. Rally captains. Kind of the worst. Look, I don't care what keeps I'm losing, as long as it's not the main one. If you don't kill that guy, I'm pretty sure the big main boss just has ridiculous damage and health, and I believe I'm at the threshold. Oh. Let's get that. Hey, buddy, what's up? Fancy meeting you here. Well, that's some slowdown. Alright, now it's time to find out. Which is the best move for killing this guy? So you compare this guy to the King Dodongo, who like takes forever to wait for him to do his move, and this guy's just like always vulnerable. Alright, let's see how this one does. That might be the move. That looked like it worked a lot better. You fool. Desperately trying to dodge out. Ah, that might have been the first move. Yeah, that might be the first move that this guy is doing that he doesn't become vulnerable after. Yeah, but while it's the same team that makes each Musou game, the map design can vary differently, like super differently between games. Oh, for the love of Christ, are you kidding me? Alright, at least he's just becoming vulnerable again. Oh boy. How'd you end up all the way over there? I didn't get it. Damn it. Are you kidding me? I must have lost something for health. No, I lost time. By 11 seconds. Are you kidding me? I'm trying to get an A rank. It unlocks a new weapon. If you A rank the stage. Like, okay. There are a couple new people in the chat. So, just a quick explanation. So here's the overall map. You know, some stages give heart pieces, some stages have Skulltulas. Oh, there's a Skulltula in that one too. Damn it. Anyway. And some stages give weapons. You can see that with like the little swords on them. In order to get the weapons, as you see in the upper left, you have to get an A rank. And that's pretty much it. Oh, God, I don't feel like doing that stage again. Yeah, I got all the stuff on these two. Oh, I have to reveal enemies on this one anyway. Let's do it. I'll show off a new character. Yeah, you have to get A ranks in all three categories. That's the stupid. And the one in the categories is health. That's the worst thing. So, like, you can't even rush. You have to be super careful. Oh, fuck. I don't want to. No, this is good. We get to show the dark side of this game. Here, okay, here's your favorite character. Everyone's favorite Zelda character, Agatha. You know, the side quest character. Let me remember how to play Agatha. I think it's... Yeah, you Moonlight Butterfly there. Or you... Yeah, she's an alright character. She does damage. There we go, it's that one. You do that, and you dodge cancel out of it. So she does damage, it's just the annoying thing of being her. Look guys, it's Tiny Imprisons. You remember the Imprison, everybody's favorite boss. I will admit that her guard break thing is fucking amazing. It is, like, super good. Does that mean I have to like it? No. No, there's the exit. I was waiting for the other one to open up. Added? Agatha's been in it since the beginning. Where's Groose? Where's my boy Groose? I like that I can just remove these threats before fights even start. Oh, hello! Hello, Volga! Hi, how are you? Yeah, but like, compare the damage, the amount of damage that her special does compared to the amount of damage that her guard break does. No. Fuck everything. Oh, she has some serious animation lock issues, and that is the main reason I hate her. But she can do this. I'm not owned. You're owned. Shut up. Got him. No! Jeez. Yep, there we go. Now I'm owned. So the re-deads obviously do that thing that re-deads do, where they freeze you, and it's the worst. Fuck. What the hell is that? I'm getting completely owned. Just trying to kill this re-dead. Can I get a... Yes, okay, there. We have a lock on. Yeah, so like... Volga, the fuck are you supposed to do against that? Look at this proud warrior being schooled by a child. I will take that. And we'll definitely probably need that. Yeah, Skull Kid is coming in the 3DS version, so there's that at least. Whoops. That's what I get for looking at chat. Yes! Good! He's here! He's here and he's ready for me. Yeah, if I fail this, or fail to get A rank, this might just be a mission I suffer through on my own time. Mainly because of this guy. Alright, so, because I know a majority of people never played it, this is a boss from Skyward Sword that you have to fight multiple times. It is actually pretty story significant, it's just really dumb. Don't want to do a third hit there. I might actually be able to do a summon. Alright, now here comes the hard part, is trying to remember how to do good damage as her. Yeah, okay, that's it. Got it. Alright, now he does this. Oh, wait, he actually didn't do it that long. Alright. Oh no, he's doing his... Yeah, that. Alright, so yeah, there you go. I just fucking lost the A rank. 100%. The imprison. This is actually one of the worst things about this game. This is like a really good game, except for this. Like anything else, you could just say, oh, this requires you to have skill and whatever. Just fuck the imprison. No, all time for the belly dance. Oh yeah, that's the other thing, is that he does a force exit of his vulnerability mode. Oh wow, I didn't actually knock him down to half health. Normally you would think, oh, that's bad, but that's actually good. Alright, though this might knock him. Yeah, now he's below half health, which means a real bad thing. So obviously this guy just looks like super tedious at this point, right? There's a reason that I got full super meter. Yeah, that's how you dodge that. You just have to keep dodging and hope that you hit the button at the right time. Okay. Yeah, look at that shit. That damages you a lot. Hopefully I can just do this. Oh, look, he's not dead. What a fucking surprise. Fuck the imprison. Like, it's okay if health wasn't a thing. If you weren't judged on health, he's kind of okay. He still sucks from a time limit standpoint. But from health, he is horrible. Oh my god. Fucking kidding me. Yeah, you're right that there are certain characters that are better for fighting them, but the fact of the matter is that they designed a system that requires you to use specific characters. Oh, wait, what? I need to see the result screen. I thought for sure I wasn't getting it. Well, thank God I don't have to do that mission again. Don't worry. There's probably like 12 that are the exact same mission. No, we're done. I don't need any of that. Oh! Somehow I didn't take enough damage. I'll take it. A weapon with a bunch of locked things on it. That might be useful. Nah, check that one off. Oh, is there an Impa map? I could do an Impa map. Impas. Oh, right. I fucked up here. They keep doing it to me. This is the... I'll zoom out to show it real fast. This is the adventure mode. And, so you get these two with the game, and then these are all DLC. So, like, here's the thing. If you want to talk about a game that has too much shit to do... This is the adventure mode. With all these maps being different stages with different requirements of what to do on them. And then you got Master Quest. Which is the same map, but with different requirements. I might hop into this. I could do a few Lana maps. Well, actually, there's a separate story mode. Which is... Yeah, there's a separate story mode, which is Legend mode. Which is... pretty good at showing you something awesome of, like, alright, so there's, you know, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, and then these, this is 10, 8, 9, 9, so that's 12, and then this is the first stage that is a repeat. And then after that, even after that, there's another new stage. And then right here, I'm almost at the end of the story mode. I get distracted by Adventure. Because Adventure gets you new weapons. Legend mode gets you new weapons to use. Adventure mode gets you new weapons to use in Legend mode. So, yeah, there's that. Alright, yeah, let's give another shot at this. I failed this last time. I think due to damage, so... Let's give that another attempt. I might have gotten a better Naginata too. Nope, that one's the strongest. Yeah. Unless any of these have good... Well, these have Fire Plus to them, but I really don't know how much that makes a difference. I'm gonna guess not much. Though... Those boosted... Strengths. Yeah, I'm just going to stick with the boosted damage. Alright, so got to get those two fairies. Then I need to bust through the two void zones. Yeah, alright. Oh, there we go. Yeah, there we go. Skill unlocked. I don't think I ever explained that, even during the last stream. So some weapons come sealed. They have sealed skills on them for a lot of that S action that you might like. And those just require you to kill so many people while using that weapon, and then you unlock the locked skill. And turn around here. There we go. Let's get the light fairy down here, and then go save people. I remember now, it was these guys. Just do your stupid fucking belly flop so I can guard break you. That's all I need from you. Not much to ask for. There we go. See, that wasn't so hard. Oh, I didn't even do it. No, whatever. Guard break not needed. That's a good move. Okay, that's another keep down. Starting to see why the skill exists to capture keeps faster. Sometimes that is just needed. Alright, so first things first. Shadow, I think, is the right way to go. Yeah. So, yeah, a lot of people are liking Impa style. I should just do a stage for shits and giggles and show off Impa's default weapon because it's probably my favorite weapon in this entire game. Come on, keep juggling. No. Oh, drop the combo. Ooh. Whoop, there we go. I got nicked. Let's just, take this keep real fast. Ooh, there's a strategy. I'm gonna try that again next time I fight one of those guys. Item thief? What just happened? Oh my god! I can't use my bombs. No, this is actually the mission for the level 3 version of this weapon. Last stream I attempted it and failed because I kind of got wrecked by the field moblins, which is sad. Alright, so I have the fairy selected. Okay, good. Get those bars used up and then activate my super mode. Yeah. Juggle. Nah. What the fucking item transporter? Get the fuck out of here. Pissing me off, item transporter. Alright, did I capture this base? I don't even remember. I did. Okay, good. We're done here. Though I do need another 500 kills. Oh, did I get the level 3 version of the Giant's Knife? I actually have no idea. I can't tell you. We'll find out. Let's just clear out these enemies. Yeah, so I dodge canceled out of the first hit. Which actually lets me get it off in one combo. There you go. There's some high-end gameplay tips for you. Nah, I fucked it up that time. There we go. Still need another 9,000 kills. Or 900. 300. Let's go get those kills. Because I do need 1,200 kills in order to... get the thing. Do the needful. And frankly, if I've gotten this far, I'm not fucking up now. What's my time looking like? Oh, I got plenty of time. I got a whole 6 minutes. Let's just farm a couple kills in here before we take the base. Whoops, there we go. Alright. No, it wasn't kills. It definitely wasn't kills last time. I remember distinctly. I got real messed up by, shield moblin at the beginning. Because, like, a shield moblin is an easy enemy to kill. But, they're the boosted, they're like the commander versions. So you actually get hit by them a couple of times and they will take, like, all your health. And luckily... Oh, I don't need that. Well, okay, let's just... And then I can take that. I need to keep an eye out and see if there's another magic pot thing anywhere. Because that really busts down bosses fast. A little zaunt. Oh, That should be good. Nice. Actually, wait, now I'm curious. Good, there's no Skulltulas in this level. As I just hit that 1200 and I was like, wait, why didn't I get an announcement? Oh no, he's doing a thing. Zant, don't do a thing. Ah, here we go. Damn it. It's only a 20 fill. I really wish there was a way to charge magic meter that didn't require an item pickup. Mainly because you can never seem to find them. Oh, come on. You kill me here. I think I might be breaking the script a little bit since I'm fighting him outside the arena. And that should be it. There we go. No. Nice! There we go. Got it. Avenging myself on some of these missions from last time. So, what is that upgrade called? Nice. It's just serrated Naginata. Also, yeah, that. Yeah. Yeah. Horse. Alright, let's go through a couple of these. Toss these. Let's just go by rank. There we go. Nice. Organized. Money. There we go. Wait, did I not? I must have gotten a weapon from Zant. Alright. Let's find a stage that will be fun real fast, just to show off base level. Maybe one that's not too long. Maybe not that kind, maybe not that kind. Maybe not limited by character. This works. I say as I switch to a different mission. Here we go. Here we go. This one. Alright, so Giant Blade. Giant's Knife is the base version. Big Ron's Knife is the level 2. I just love the concept of a human wielding the Big Ron's Knife. So yeah, apparently I don't have the level 3 version. I don't know where that is. It might be in a stage. That's what it is. Or maybe in one of those top map areas. Anyway. So, you know, big ass sword. But just really throws it around real well. Oh yeah, also her Naginata is, what's the word I'm looking for? Naginata is fire based and the Vigoron knife is water based. It's also just like, it's one of the best weapons in the game, too. Alright, anyway, let's... Wait, this is the level 3 knife? I don't think so. I'll check the weapons again afterwards. Oh, did I already kill the guy? Nice. Also, that! One of the best specials! I mean, mind you, this is also one of the earliest stages in the game. So it's going to be easier. Oh, also chickens. Ah, some real... Some quality Dynasty Warrior slowdown right here. People complain about slowdown in Dynasty Warriors games. I just know that's how I know I'm doing something cool. Anyway, let's just go finish this real fast and move on to a different mission. Which one was it? 7 or 8? I want to say it was 8. 8 had the tremendously horrible lag. Dynasty Warriors 8, I should say. Clarify. That was the one where Chibi was actually unplayable. Also, that's a great noise. And then this, the victory animation is also one of my favorites. This is good. Oh no, I didn't get the, ended clear on kills. Who would have thought? But yeah, let's just take a look at that real fast. I thought I saw only... It didn't look like the damage is right. Yeah. The Biggeron's, the Biggeron's sword. Oh, yeah, look at that. Huh. Da-da-da-da. Yeah, okay, you did mention the sword, and I was confused because there's a sword and the knife. God, how did I miss that? Anyway. Wii U characters, okay, so what they have confirmed is that if you own the 3DS version, and is this another Zelda map? I was like, here, I'll show off Zelda, and it's just another Zelda map where it's these fuckers. Alright. If you get the 3DS version, you can transfer the characters to the Wii U. No confirmation on if they will just become DLC eventually, which is kind of what they should do, but they're probably trying to milk those, like, initial sales. I mean, frankly, I would buy it for the 3DS anyway, because from what I've seen, it runs pretty well, but, you know, we'll see. Alright, so we saw these before, but I need to clear maps in order to get the other maps. Actually, let's just clear out a few of these so I don't get nicked by these. For those that are new, I'll just do a quick explanation. This is a map where everything's a one-hit kill for both you and the enemies. So I'm clearing out the BMOS, so that way I do not get clipped by BMOS and then get very angry. Oh, hello. Unfortunately, you cannot lock on to BMOS, so there's that. And then, remember how I said, well, not going to be showing off this character again, because the best way to do this is to use the bow and arrow. Let's get that last BMOS. Again. All right, good. All right, so now we just do our circles around the map, killing these fat man with nipple tassels, which is just weird. Well, not weird. I mean, you know, to each their own. But it's weird in a Nintendo game. I mean, to be mentioned that the princess is actually pretty good with a rapier. Yeah, you know. Just kind of good. Just kind of alright. And then, you know, there's the good old light arrow. For when you really just need to own someone. I mean, I guess I could just run up and slap people. But then I run the risk of getting hurt myself. No. Oh, hello. And line it up. 2-for-1. Dodging all my shots. I'm not actually a super fan of these missions, just because they are pretty base and simple. And there you go. But it's simple enough so that you can get your treasure. And you know, so sometimes you have these bullshit conditional missions, so I'll take these. Alright, so who's up here? Oh, that's right, I failed to get that one again. That's some... Huh. Zant, huh? I could drop Zant. Zant's a weird character. Zant is... super bizarre. Like, it's an A to unlock this map. But it's a C from this direction. 23 weapon there. Yeah. Yeah, let's do a Zant. Is that still my best one? That's good ass. Has a lot of slots, but not the stars. Oh, I got these. These are way better. Alright, so Zant. Zant's a weird character because his whole gimmick is getting angry. And then spinning the wind. I'm not even kidding. It's esports. Okay, so you need to clear people out of Zant. Well, alright, so now my meter's full, and then I hit this button, and then I go into a tizzy. Oh, hold up. Real talk. If that is the gimmick you are playing game, I'm taking care of that shit before I do anything else. Oh, with bomb chews? Oh, lord. So the gimmick of bomb chews is that they they slowly move to a location, and then when they get there you have limited time, and then they explode. So there's a bomb chew about to go off, and then there's also a manhandle. Alright, that's dead. Get to the other one. This is a lot of running around, this one. Alright, so I should be able to... Oh, by the way, the reason that there's this temple to Link, that's actually a thing. There's actually a reason. I can get into it because that's story stuff. Oh, bomb chews are so annoying. They're just like, here's these things that you have to take care of ASAP. Whereas, like, yeah, it's like, hey, your central chamber's about to fall. It's like, I can't, I gotta get the bomb chew. I can't go take care of that. Oh no, it's Dankrutu. I used to hate Zant. That was mainly because I didn't understand how to play him. And then you figure out a character's gimmick and you're like, no, actually this character owns. They're actually really good. Another one?! You're killing me here, game. Mort. Good. This is fine. Yeah, like Madai. Madai was such a weird character. They're just like, he's got a brush. And you're like, I don't... How do I kill with brush? And then you're like, oh, actually you're laying down bombs. Hold up. I just saw a timer start, and I have no idea where there's a bomb chew going off. Rutu. Dankrutu. Alright, got it. Love to take you out, Rutu, right now, but I do not have the time. Also, Yulana. At least I'm getting the kills. Look, dog. Dog. We acknowledge the dog. Thank God this move exists. Oh, I should probably... Yeah, I should probably demonstrate that mechanic of Zant. Oh, I think I just did. So if you let the meter get too big, Zant gets messed up. Do not let Zant's meter get too huge. Oh, I lost a keep? Damn it. Maybe if I get the keep back, it'll fix this. Yes, okay, good. Alright. So, here's the strategy for officers as Zant. You go up on your big pillar. And then you spin. That is it. You do this over and over again. Why? Because it is the best strategy. It might not be the best, most amazing thing to do, but it is in fact the most effective. Now if you'll excuse me, I'm going to up the volume on my pad here. And we gotta go on a speed hunt. It's close by. There we go. And we are gonna get the fuck away from that manhandler. I just took this back. Guys, please. Thank you. Well, let's just remove you from the base. How about that, huh? I'm not actually sure. Oh, I fucked up. I fucked up bad. I was talking. That's probably one of the better moves to fuck up it with as Zant. It does increase the fastest, but you're stunned for the least amount of time. Alright, so that's Rutu dead. The dank Rutu. Was she like immune for a second there? That sucks. All right, there. That should kill her. And I'm still not sure how to stop my bases from getting owned. Oh, I messed up. I don't remember killing the manhandle stalks, but if you say I did. Main chamber's about to fall. Like, this is it. This is a good example of Dynasty Warriors endgame. Just running around from place to place. But being cool while you do it. It just feels good. Alright. Somebody is calling out Lana as being a bad character. In concept and design, yes. Yes, she is not that great of a character. In execution, her book is a real good weapon, and I have to show that off now. Luckily, I think there is, either on this stage or on the Master Quest stage, there is a Lana map. So, I will have my chance. I mean, I'm not happy about the character. I think she's a little annoying. And a bit too much of that, like, you know, Japanese culture. Ooh, look at the cute character. But gameplay-wise, she's fine. Alright, let's just finish this fast. With that little bread and butter for taking out generals. Like, I don't kid when I say that this is, like, the most effective way to take out generals. It works really well. Sia is fine. She's... Again, like, okay, here's the thing. The biggest complaint I have with Lana and Sia is... To a lesser extent, Lana. But... to an extent, it feels like they belong fine in a Zelda universe, but, like, when you really take a good look at them, they just seem out of place. And it's just, like, it's blatantly obvious. Fuck. The good old special cancel. I'm not owned. No, I'm not owned. Like, you can blatantly see that they were designed by Koei and not, like, Zelda. Nintendo probably had some input in the design. I'd have to imagine that they wouldn't just allow Koei to 100% design character. But to me, it just feels like that both those characters kind of reek that they're out of place. Doing a little dance there? Nah, I'm fucking with my buttons. This combo can actually work way better if you can constantly keep the damage on them. Yeah, right now I have the dark hit on her. So that means if I keep hitting her, it'll do increased damage. But if I drop a combo, then she stops taking increased damage for a bit. She, like, doesn't have it now, and then she gets it again. So if I could just keep that going. And then she always blocks. Eh, whatever, this is the last one I'll need to do. So yeah, let's hop over to the, a couple more minutes. Let's hop over to the Master Quest map and show off Lana. Oh, nice. Let's get rid of this one. This one. Let's see what that last... I'll keep that this to find out what that last skill is. That one. That one. And then all the rest of these. Nice! Picture. Alright, so it's over here to reveal the item. And then I need a fairy harp to get that one, which would be right here. But I don't feel like doing that map. Yeah, alright, we can just leave these for later. Nope, wrong map. Alright. That's not a good example. That's not a good one to do it on. I might be limited on my weapon selection here. No, I'm not. Okay, Book of Sorcery. Oh, yeah. All Terminator map's got gimmicks to it. Alright, so loop around the top, get the ferry, bottom right. Yeah, alright. Okay, so this is Lana. Her main gimmick is making cubes that do things. This is the other gimmick. So her standard standing thing is like, oh, okay, it's a little flip. Unless you have a cube. If you have a cube and you dodge into the cube, you can detonate cube. Whoops, 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 I say over and over again as I keep dodging into attacks. So a good example is like you do the 1, 2, 3. You make the no, this isn't the right one. It's the 1, 2. Yeah, you make the electric cube, you dodge forward, and then you dodge into the cube, and you detonate cube. I should probably not let that bomb to self-destruct in the base. The main annoying thing about Lana, and I mentioned this last stream, is the fact that she just is constantly saying ready go in Japanese over and over and over again, and a repeating voice clip can get on my nerves pretty fast. Alright, this is awesome! This is great! It's such a great style of fighting. Just cube. Respect cubes. Oh, I'm gonna lose another base. Should probably stop that from happening. Oh no, the lizard bros are on the field, wrecking shit up. Of course, you can just, you know, use most of these moves on their own, and they're pretty good. You don't have to detonate them. Just detonate them. Usually does more damage. I can't remember if it was an A rank or a find it for the heart piece. Oh yeah, Silver Cuckoo. I actually don't know the gimmick of the Silver Cuckoo, but I'm going to guess, like most situations with cuckoos, I ignore it and hope it doesn't fuck me up. Oops, oops, there we go. Yeah. I'm going to guess that if it is a stage pickup heart piece, it's going to be down here. Ally base in danger of... Oh, that's the big base. That's the base that I don't want to fall. Fuck. Fuck ass. Shit. Ah, I'm messing up my combos. Yeah, like I said, people are saying it in chat. Her yelling, ready, go, over and over, over and over. It can be really annoying. Why? Okay, let's find out what the deal with this stupid silver cuckoo is. And see if we just need to rough it up a bit. And we'll never know. Anyway, time to rush. Just clear off this bridge that was made for me. Yes, good. Will that slow down? Ah, fuck. Where you at? There it is. Oh, okay, for a second I thought I hit the wrong button. Taking a shortcut through here. Bye. It seems to be a speedrun mission, so I don't need to worry about time limit. Just need to worry about kills, and I bet you this is where the heart piece is. And can you believe I've done, like, I streamed this for about 5 hours almost at this point, and there's still characters I haven't shown off, like, a lot. There's just a ton of characters in this game, and they all play pretty well. Alright. I mean, to be fair, I don't think I've actually legit shown off Zelda yet. Because every time I pick her, it's just one of those, hey, Everything dies in one hit maps. Whoops. I'm not owned, you're owned. You gotta keep the jungle going. Damn. Dropped my combos. I'll show off horse next time. Yeah, like there's a list of things I still need to show off in this game, and also I could probably just keep playing this game forever. I mean, hell, I haven't shown off Ganon yet. Or Ganondorf. The big man. I'm an anime. Okay. That's it for now. That was a good almost 2 hours. And I have plans, to be honest. But I could definitely keep streaming this game. Because it's a good game for streaming. But for now. There's the saving. And we're done. For today. But I'll see you next time.